Hey everyone, thanks for tuning into CryptoZX. I really appreciate you stopping by my channel today. To all my viewers watching my video right now, can I please ask you guys to smash that like button and hit the red subscribe button if you haven't already. This does help with the channel tremendously and it also keeps me motivated on making videos for you guys. But with that being said, let's jump right in today's content. Alright guys, before I begin, I would like to say the disclaimer, anything on this channel should not be taken as financial advice because I am not a financial advisor. Cryptocurrencies are super volatile, so please do your own due diligence and research before investing in these markets. Looking at the overall crypto market cap today, we're currently sitting at $1.775 trillion. We're up 3.5% in the last 24 hours. Meanwhile, BTC dominance is currently sitting at 40%. Looking at the overall markets, guys, we are finally starting to see green across the board, especially after last night. If you guys don't know what happened yesterday, we did have Elon Musk come out and tweet about Bitcoin. Basically, you know, a tweet that had people panic because the tweet was initially a heartbroken emoji along with the Bitcoin logo. A lot of people started speculating, wait, did he sell his Bitcoin? Is he talking bad about Bitcoin? And you guys know what happens when Elon Musk tweets, that, you know, the whales tend to take massive advantage of that tweet. So we did see the markets tank towards the downside. But since then, guys, markets are rebounding very, very quickly. So that's a bullish indicator in my opinion. But today, guys, I want to look more into XRP and then we will talk about Bitcoin as well. So XRP family, if we're looking at XRP's price right now, we're trading at 99.8 cents. We're up 6.9% in the last 24 hours in USD comparative. We're also up 3.5% in BTC comparative in just the last 24 hours. XRP's current rank on CoinMarketCap and on CoinGecko is at the top 7th spot. Market cap right now is $46 billion. Meanwhile, 24-hour trading volume is at $4.11 billion. Zooming out and looking at the bigger picture for XRP, guys, in just the last year alone, we're still up 387.1%. In the last 30 days, yes, we are down 38.2%, but guys, this should not come as a surprise to all of us now because we know what has been going on in the markets over the last 3 weeks. So, you know, we need to put that into perspective as to why we're seeing these numbers. But I believe as long as Bitcoin does go towards the upside and reaches specific price targets that I have been mentioning, specifically that $46,600 level, I believe Ripple XRP will rebound, you know, organically with Bitcoin's price. But I want to share, you know, a very, very bullish article with you guys. And, you know, then we will look into the price analysis for XRP and see what's going on and where we could be headed in the immediate short term. So let's waste no time and let's get right into that. Ripple files a motion requesting SEC to hand over documents related to the ongoing complaint. So lawyers representing Ripple Labs, its CEO Brad Gelinghaus, and a co-founder, you know, Chris Larsen, filed a motion Friday to compel the SEC to produce two sets of documents that the company requested earlier this year, guys. The documents relate to SEC communications with third parties regarding Bitcoin, XRP, Ethereum. Ripple is seeking to force the SEC to disclose why it came to the conclusion that Bitcoin and Ethereum are commodities, not securities like XRP. Last December, the SEC filed a complaint alleging that Ripple raised over $1.3 billion through an unregistered ongoing digital asset securities offering. The agency is seeking injunctive relief. We allege that Ripple, Larsen, and Gerlinghaus failed to register their ongoing offer and sale of billions of XRP to retail investors, which deprived potential purchasers of adequate disclosure of XRP. On April 6th and May 6th, United States Magistrate Judge Sarah Netburn of New York Southern District had ordered the SEC to provide the documents, but the agency has yet to comply, citing relevance. The two sides have met independently 5 times to try to resolve the issue, most recently on June 1st, according to the Ripple motion. At CoinDesk's Consensus 2021 event last month, Gerlinghaus said he felt the case had broader repercussions for how cryptocurrency is viewed in the US. So, you know, this is very, very bullish, guys. And we are starting to see more and more positive things come out in favor of Ripple. You guys can see Ripple is demanding SEC to come and explain as to why they said Bitcoin and Ethereum are commodities. Meanwhile, XRP is a security. And so far, SEC has not complied with this request. And also, one other bullish thing that I like is that both of the parties have independently, try to resolve this case that is going on. But so far, we have not come to a conclusion. But everything is starting to pile up, guys. And I believe in the next month or so, this might actually come to an end. And I will keep you guys posted as time goes by and, you know, keep you guys updated as to what is going on. So very, very bullish in my opinion. But now let's deep dive into the charts and see what's exactly going on for XRP and Bitcoin. All right, guys, XRP family, if you guys know, we were trading at $1.08 before we did see before we saw this pullback down to 91 cents. So if you guys don't know why this happened, we had a flash crash just yesterday at 7 p.m. because the man himself, Elon Musk, came out and made a tweet, which, like I said earlier in this video, was a bearish tweet, and a lot of people did panic. And one thing I don't like right off the bat about this is because, guys, Elon Musk, I believe, is not right for the space. Don't get me wrong. I love the dude. I believe he's an absolute genius. But, you know, the amount of power he holds from his tweets is absolutely insane. And I believe it's not good for a new upcoming asset class, like in the cryptocurrency space. It's, very scary that how his tweets have so much impact in the space. Obviously, at the beginning, it was very, very nice. He was bringing in a lot of mainstream hype into the cryptocurrency space because at the end of the day, we do need that. With the Dogecoin mania, along with coming out and saying Tesla will be accepting Bitcoin as a payment method. But right shortly after, guys, the tweet came out, we will no longer be accepting a Bitcoin because environmental issues, because of mining powers. That has really created this entire downward trend for Bitcoin. And as soon as we did see some sort of bullish momentum towards the upside, what a coincidence, right, guys? He comes out and makes another tweet, and whales take 100% advantage of his tweets because they know how much power his tweets hold. So we did see manipulation occur several times after his tweets. But, you know, XRP did have a retracement towards the downside, obviously, because Bitcoin, at the end of the day, I always say, is the leading indicator of the entire market. So we did see Bitcoin go towards the downside, and obviously XRP did fall back below, but we are having a, rebound so far. I would like still for XRP to get back into this range, guys, at that $1.17 mark. This is my next price target, as I have mentioned. I believe we could touch that possibly if Bitcoin does continue to go towards the upside. We might see some choppiness around this level, guys, as I have mentioned, because this is going to play as a resistance level for us. So do expect us to have some sort of choppiness level around here. But I believe that we will not have any problems breaking above it and get back into this 0.50 Fibonacci retracement level that I have been talking about and how crucial this level of support really is. And I'm a strong believer that we will be able to reach that as long as Bitcoin does not have another shakeoff. So let's look at Bitcoin's price and then come and make a conclusion as to what we can see happen with XRP in the next coming, week or so. So if we're looking at Bitcoin's price right now, guys, so this was where the tweet came out. What a coincidence, right, guys? As soon as everything started to look good, we were like, guys, you guys know me. I was talking about that. We need to break above that $38,200 mark and everything will start to look good. And we will be heading towards one of these two important levels of, support. Most importantly, that $46,600 level. As soon as we broke that, everyone started getting excited. Wow, markets are headed towards the upside. Woohoo. Guess what happens, guys, right off the bat? Elon Musk comes and makes a tweet and boom, we go towards a downside like expected because at the end of the day, like I said, he does hold a lot of power in the space. But one thing I want to point out right off the bat, the bullish thing is that, this level of support really did play out very strongly for Bitcoin. We weren't able to break below it and head towards this last level of support that basically I said is basically either do or die for Bitcoin at that $33,100 mark. We did bounce back up from the support level. So far, so good, but I am not excited, guys. We need to get above this level first. And then, I believe things will start looking good unless he comes out and makes another tweet. I hope not. But we need to get above back to this level, guys. This level is very, very crucial. And once we do get above here, guys, I am a strong believer that, the bottom is in and we are indeed headed towards the upside. But Bitcoin needs to do sideways trading around this level. We can't just do this, go up, boom, back down. No, guys, we need to hold around these levels for at least a day or two for me to be convinced that yes, the bottom is in and we are headed towards the upside. But so far, so good. Let's hope this is not a fake out. But guys, if this is a fake out, you guys know we have to look at the bearish scenario. I would like for us to bounce back up once again from this support level. As you guys can see, these support levels do play out very, very crucially when the price does go towards the downside. And you guys can see that right in front of us. But if we are unable to hold around this level, guys, then, you know, we have a high chance of falling back down to $33,000. And this is basically the last support level. If we're unable to hold this, guys, this whole upwards trend, higher lows, will be invalidated. And there's a high chance of Bitcoin to fall back down to $25,000, which would obviously create a lot of panic across the board. And that would mean that XRP could go back down to these price levels or even further down. Again, guys, you know, we have to look at all the realistic outcomes, and this is an outcome as of now. Unless we reach $46,600 level, then I would be more on the confident side of the spectrum as to, you know, the bottom is in and we are headed towards the upside. Right now, I'm not going to make that claim. You guys know me. I keep it 100% realistic with you guys. I'm not going to come out and telling you guys, you know what, guys? The bottom is in and we are headed towards the upside and we're about to see all-time highs tomorrow. No, that's not how it works, guys. We look at all the scenarios and come up with the most possible outcome. So if Bitcoin does go towards the upside, like I mentioned, this is the next price target in the immediate short term. But if we do head to that $46,600 mark, guys, I would not be surprised if we are trading within this 0.50 Fibonacci retracement level. But again, only time will tell. All eyes are still on Bitcoin. And as this SEC lawsuit expands and we come to a conclusion, so far, we're starting to hear a lot of good announcement coming in, guys. A lot of people are getting excited. And as you guys may know, I always say this, let's not underestimate the power of XRP, guys. XRP community is massive, massive community, strong supporters, diehard supporters, and the project itself keeps on delivering, guys. This is the most bullish news out of, you know, this makes me super bullish. Out of the, you know, even though they are facing some extremely uncertain times, you know, a lot of stress. If they weren't a serious company, they would be like, you know, drop everything and we're just going to be focusing on this lawsuit. But no, guys, XRP is delivering. They keep on making new partnerships and they just keep on expanding as a business. And that's a bullish indicator on its own, guys. And I am a strong believer that this lawsuit will come in the favor of Ripple. And, you know, we are already starting to see hints of that occur. And you guys know, I always said, if the official announcement comes out and that they say that this lawsuit has been settled, we will see XRP fly through the roof as long as Bitcoin does not have a flash crash. Let's keep that in mind as well, because if Bitcoin goes towards the downside, everything is invalidated, guys. But, you know, as soon as this official announcement were to come out, I believe XRP is going to see some newer all-time highs this year, even further than its all-time high from back in 2018. I'm a strong believer on that. There's still a lot of money on the sidelines, guys, and there's whales accumulating. The people that do believe in XRP from day one, they're accumulating while there's major, major fear across the board. And, you know, that just goes to show how big this community is and how much they really do believe in it. And obviously, if this lawsuit were to get dropped, guys, this is going to be a very bullish thing for the price. And also, Girlinghaus come out and say, you know, we will be looking into going public right after this comes to a conclusion. And, you know, once that news gets priced in as well, sky's the limit for XRP, guys. And I have mentioned, you guys can go look this for yourself. A project like XRP that has built up its credibility over the years is only up 387.1% in the last 1 year. Meanwhile, majority of the top currencies, guys, are up 1,000, 2,000, 3,000%. So you guys get the picture as to where I'm headed. And right now, all eyes are on Bitcoin, and I will keep you guys updated if anything were to happen. And if you know, you guys need to be notified, I will come and tell you guys right off the bat. But this is what is looking for XRP. Everything is starting to look good, but again, all eyes should be on Bitcoin. But this is it for today's video, guys. If you guys did enjoy the video, can you please like this video and hit the bell icon? This does help my channel grow and, you know, reach my videos to a wider audience. I would greatly appreciate your guys' support. And thank you to each and every one of you guys for showing so much support. I love each and every one of you guys from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And also, guys, come join the Telegram group chat, guys. What are you waiting for? It's free to join. A link in the description box below. We talk about cryptocurrencies, the latest news and trends revolving around the space, and just have a great time at the end of the day. So come join the group and let's build this community together. But with that being said, guys, don't forget safety, health, and family comes first, and everything else absolutely comes later. It's been CryptoZX, and peace out.